Hello guys and welcome back to my channel. So today we're gonna be filming a super fun video. We're gonna be filming the storybook collection. So I got this in a BoxyCharm around this time last year, and I literally messed with it probably once or twice, and then I was like, no, because I didn't like the way the look turned out and it looked like muddy and patchy. But I actually really like the way this look turned out. Definitely have to trust the process, have a little faith in yourself. But if you guys want to see how I created this look, definitely keep on watching. And let's just jump straight into the video. All right, so we are barefaced. I literally have nothing on my face. So we're going to start with the eyebrows. I think I have my mirror down here, like below the camera. So hopefully it looks fine. All right, I haven't filmed in a while, so I'm feeling kind of like jumbled. I don't know what I'm doing. All right, so we're gonna start with the Makeup Revolution. This is their brow pencil. I got this a while ago. The only thing that I don't like about it is a little bit waxy and it's kind of hard, like you have to press hard to get any like paint, like a pigment. But it might just be because it's a little bit older now. I'm just gonna fill my eyebrows in. Fix my posture. Oh, there's my neighbors. Alright. Basically, I just fill this in. Honestly, don't do a lot because my eyebrows are already pretty thick. I just have to like work on like the this part. And just cleaning up underneath, like to make it look nice and sharp. That's pretty much it. All right, I'm going to finish my eyebrows and then I will fast forward to the next part for y'all. Now that my eyebrows are completely done, what I'm gonna be doing is I'm gonna start prepping our eye base so we could get into that. So I'm just gonna be using the Milani eyeshadow primer. This is the light white invisible. Works in all skin tones. This is just the nude one. I think they have a couple other shades. Yeah, this is in 01 nude. So a little bit goes a long way. So I'm just going to place a little dot there. Bella, why are you breathing like that, girl? She's fine, I swear. All right, so we're just gonna tap that on the eyelid. So I'm just going to be using the Maybelline New York Fit Me. This is the loose finishing powder. And this is in the shade 05 Fair. Now this one is way too light. But I do use it sometimes. And most of the time I use it to set like my, if I do a cut crease or something like that. So I'm just going to be taking a big Shim Glams brush. I got this from BoxyCharm like a while ago. This is the small contouring W07 brush. And we're just gonna be taking that powder and just setting that primer to give us a nice little base. Now you can either, you don't have to set it if you don't want to. If you don't set it, it does make the colors a little bit more vibrant. But I'm just gonna set it because I need a little bit more coverage. You guys see my tumbler? It's so pretty. This is my Christmassy one. Let me turn off the light. So it says baby it's cold outside and we got all our little, it's supposed to be like a North Pole, Northern Lights type thing. And you have all your little snowmen on there. It's really cute. My mom made it for me. So that is my Christmas tumbler. And yeah. That's what we've been doing, really. We've gotten lots of Christmas orders, especially on our Etsy and stuff like that. If you want to check our Etsy out, it's down below. I'll link it there. And we also have a TikTok where we film some of the, like, the videos or some of the cups that we are making for like customers and stuff like that. But yeah, so we've been really busy with that. So if you want to check it out, let me know what you guys think about it. If you guys like that kind of stuff. I definitely think I want to film us making a Christmas or like a tumbler in general. So if you want to see that, let me know down below and we'll definitely make that happen. I know my mom would love to do that for you guys. But we're going to start jumping into the eyeshadow. So first of all, let's talk about this packaging. It is so freaking cute. Like, this is just something that you could have on your vanity and beautiful.
Huber?
I don't know. I'm sorry if I'm butchering that. It's this beautiful mustard shade right here. You know, I love me some yellows. Ooh. I want to get my hands on... Oh, yeah. See, now the dogs are barking because they know she's home. I want to get my hands on the ColourPop, the honey palette, the yellow palette. Ooh, that's a vibe. It's a vibe. All right, so we are gonna blend that. I literally have no idea on what I'm using or what I'm gonna do. That's what I mean. Ah, where'd my dog go? Oh, she's over farther. So yeah, I'm just gonna pack this on and blend it out. I'm using the Morphe brush. This is like part of a collection. This honestly is not my favorite brush. The bristles actually hurt my eye. Like, they're too stiff. I even tried like washing them and putting coconut oil or conditioner, something to make it softer, and they don't. It just scratches my eye. So we're gonna put a little bit more quiver. And it's almost like a caramel color, to be honest. It's not really mustard. I mean, it looks mustard in the pan, but it's more like a caramely color, but it's super pretty. So yeah, that's what I did. But anyways, I think I'm gonna go in with Merry Man, which is this green right here, just really nice green. All right, this one's dirty, but we're just gonna have to deal with it. So I'm gonna go in with Merry Man. Oh my God, my brother's dog's barking now. So I couldn't get the dogs to stop barking. So basically what I'm doing is just taking the shade Merry Men, and I'm just going to be putting this in the crease and the outer V, and I'm just going to be blending it so it looks all nice and neat. And then I'm going to go ahead and speed it up for you guys. That way this video isn't too long. It's pretty explanatory. I literally just went back between Cuber and Merry Men and just went back and forth until it was blended the way I liked it. So now I'm just going to be taking a smaller brush and going in with the darkest shade in the palette, which is going to be Forest. And I'm just taking this on a ColourPop small crease brush. And I'm going to be putting this in the outer V, and I'm just going to be packing it right there so I can build up the pigment. And then once I get it pigmented enough, I'm going to start blending it into the crease. So basically that's what I did. Going to be using the 16 hour camo concealer. This is in light peach. We're just gonna we're gonna try and do like the spotlight. Now we'll just cut crease it because I suck at those. Okay, this is what I always do. So I start from the inner part of my eye and I just do that. Take some more concealer. I got more concealer. We're just going to cut that, baby. Cutting the crease makes everything look better, to be honest. I ain't gonna lie. Last time when I did the look, I used the gold. So this time I want to use the green. This is in Robin Hood. Oh, I got hair. Cat hair. I'm going to use some of Robin Hood. I'm just going to like dig my finger in there. Dig it. Oh, she's nice and pretty. And then the mirror on this one sucks. I ain't going to lie. It's very like foggy. Oh, maybe I should use a different color. It's fine. It's fine. It's fine. It's fine. It's fine. We're just going to. It's really dark. There's like no like pizzazz to it. I don't know, it's kind of pretty. Go back in with some of the darker shades just to like deepen her up. Fun fact. So this color, you know what this reminds me of? My mom used to have this car when we were kids, and it was green, like this color green. And it was the cherry car because we made it green and then the interior was red, like a cherry. I don't know why that just popped in my head, but that's what it reminds me of. I think I'm gonna go into the 39L Hit the Lights palette from Morphe. This is like one of my go-to palettes. I literally use this for everything, to be honest. Let's see. So these are kind of like toppers in a way. So they don't come out very pigmented. They're literally just like a glittery sheen almost. So I think I'm gonna take this one right here. It's the shade Glitz On. It comes with this little plastic thingy that you have to keep for their names. But I always put it on backwards. So I'm gonna take a little bit of that sheen on my finger. Why do I keep picking up that mirror? Oh, there's a plastic film on it. Maybe that's why it sucks. Yeah. Ah, it's better now. All right. Yes, much better, y'all. All right. We're gonna put that on there. Just to give it a little bit more dimension. Just give it a little oomph, oomph. Oh, baby. Look at that. That is what I'm talking about right there, man. A little glitter. Video is gonna be literally like a million years long. So what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna go off camera and do my makeup and do my face makeup, I mean. And then I will be back to finish off the eyes. So we're gonna go back into the storybook thing and we're just going to finish up the lower lash. I actually really like the way this like looks, especially when you put your foundation and all that on, it just brings the look together. Yeah, so. I'm going to find a little small brush. This is from e.l.f. I think. Yes, this is the e.l.f. eyeshadow brush. She's very dirty. So I'm just going to be taking a little bit of the caramely shade in Quibert. I have no clue how to say that. I'm so sorry. All right, tap the excess. And we're just going to piece of skin right there. I can't talk and do this. We're just going to brush her up in there. Use this one. This is the Lexi 239 Precision Shading Brush. Their brushes are so freaking good. They're so good. All right, Merriman, which is the green shade. We're gonna tap, tap, tap. And we're going to just put this from your pupil back. I think that's right, right? I'll put y'all up in there. So, I thought I was recording for like the last 10 minutes of doing my makeup, but apparently I was not. So, basically, what I did was, I don't even know, did I record my lash, doing my lash line? I did my lower lash line on camera. I guess we'll figure out, I'll find out if that was recorded or not. I went in with my ColourPop BFF, my foot's starting to fall asleep. My ColourPop BFF mascara. This is in the shade Black on Black. So I just went ahead and used that on my top lashes. I went in with the Lights Camera Lashes from Tarte, and I got this from Ulta. This was like one of their birthday masks. My birthday was in October. So this is their little gift for if your birthday was in October. So I got it for free. This is like their limited edition packaging for the birthday. But I actually really like this mascara. I've been using it mostly every time I do my, when I wear makeup. So I went ahead and just put this over the ColourPop mascara and then I did it on my bottom lashes. We're gonna set the makeup. So this is the Rimmel London. This is the Stay Matte Fix and Go one. It's almost empty. It's like $4, super cheap. $4, super cheap, lasts forever. Makes everything look nice and pretty. All right, guys, so that is the end of today's video. I had no clue what I was about to say. But I really like the way the makeup turned out at like the middle of it. Once I was adding the shade Merryman, I was like, ooh, I don't know if this is gonna turn out how I want it to. And then when I put Forest on, I was like, this is not how I imagined the look, but trust the process. Blending, definitely makes a difference. But I actually really love the way the look turned out. It's definitely different. I never wear greens, so you know, this is interesting for me. But I actually really like the palette. This is just one that I got from BoxyCharm. I think that they might sell this one or like a bigger size of it with a couple more shades. And they have a red one that I really, really want to try now. So I might have to get that one. But this is the Robin Hood edition. So definitely go check this out. The formulas are amazing and I really love the way the look turned out. So if you guys want to see more videos like this, definitely make sure to give it a thumbs up. Remember, you guys are beautiful, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye!